Hello once again, Buzz Killington here, and if you're watching this, the Neurothrope event is about to begin, if it hasn't begun already, assuming you're not watching this on a day of video release, and why wouldn't you be? In any case, I thought I would do a quick video about this, primarily aimed at newish players, so old hands, feel free to not pay too much attention to this. I'm aware I'm just drastically diminishing my audience simply by saying that, but I thought I would do a quick video to give some hints and tips to new players on basically how to get the most out of this two-week Neurothrope event. Some of the tips may be obvious, they probably are, but you never know which tips might help people. There are always good suggestions, there's always things you forget. And if you play your cards right, you can really hit the event running and make a lot of progress very, very quickly. So I did have this mental list of things I was going to go through, and I'm going to try and do it in no particular order. So for starters, stock up. You want to be stocked up on energy. You want to be stocked up on tokens for all the events. That means Saturday really should be a pretty quiet day for you in terms of gaming on here. So just to bear in mind, there are not one, not two, but three events. Where you will part of the free event missions where part of the conditions is that you will need 20 arena battles. So with that in mind, you want to be starting event day with 15 arena battles saved up in the pot. They do delay you. There is one event as well where you are required to do three salvage run missions. So bear in mind, of course, as we all know, you can only save up two tokens. So when you reach that mission, you are looking at a guaranteed 12-hour delay, because obviously it takes that long for a salvage run token to recharge. So with that in mind, when you reach that mission, you want to have both tokens there. Otherwise, it's really going to delay you even further. I mean, could delay you a full day in total. It could delay you just a few additional hours on top of the 12. But either way, if you're wanting to make progress, it's irritating. It's irritating as hell. And obviously, if you're like me, you start the day pretty much with full energy anyway, because like I get up like 7-8 hours after the reset time. So some of you people will be hitting the ground running ahead of me. That's why I'm never going to be number one in events, simply because, you know, I like my sleep. My sleep is important. But you should be starting things off with a decent event energy pool as well. Good night's sleeps are important, folks. So here's another thing to bear in mind. For the 2 weeks that the event is running, the event should always be the first thing you're thinking about. What do I mean by this? Basically, you log on to Tacticus for the first time. Oh, the Neurothrope event has started, or the Neurothrope event's ongoing, whatever day you're on. And you're like, oh, I'll just do a little bit of this before I start looking at the mission requirements. No. This will always delay you. You can waste energy doing like normal stuff that you could be using in the event. There's obviously events have specific conditions. There's you like do certain Xeno, kill a certain number of Xenos, do a certain number of raids. If you're spending your energy or doing other game modes unwisely, it will hold you up. So always the first thing that I try to do when a 2 week event running is look at my mission, see what I can do to push that forward first. And only when I've absolutely reached a stalling point on those missions do I then do other game modes if necessary. For instance, I've played a 20 arena mission, I've done my 15, I've got 5 or 6 hours until the remaining 5 arena tokens drop. That's the time to start thinking, what other game modes can I do to get my daily missions done? Daily missions are lower priority than making progress in the event, really. I mean, obviously you may be fairly relaxed about it, but I'm not. I want to get all the missions done as quickly as I can, because obviously the 20th mission, you have to win 250 battles. 250. That's a lot of raiding. That will take a lot of time. Like, you may have all the tokens in the world, which apparently I do, and I can't get rid of them. You're not going to have that level of energy. So that is going to hold you up, and you want to be doing that 20th mission quite early in the competition, quite early in a 2 week period, maybe with a week to go, maybe with 5 days to go or something. Gives you plenty of time to get it done, takes the pressure off you. Bear in mind as well that once the 20th mission is done, you get an additional mission, which is the same conditions, another 250. But you get a requisition scroll out of that. So that is always to the good. Speaking of requisition scrolls, you may notice I have 35 of them. Why am I not doing any 10 pulls? Where is my rubbish 10 pull video where I unlock all these completely rubbish things, nothing of which I want? I'm waiting, because you got to wait for the event to drop, and then that creature you're trying to create, the character you're trying to unlock, sorry, I can't talk, will be in requisition pool. So yeah, there's like the Thousand Sun that I could be collecting, could be trying for, but I'm going to wait until the Neurothrope is in the pool, because then you've got the chance of collecting more shards to help you unlock the Neurothrope even further than you have been already. So yeah, hold on to those scrolls if there's an event coming. Energy. You've got to use your energy efficiently. Obviously, there's specific missions, there'll be specific requirements. The simple raid ones are quite straightforward. There'll be ones like, oh, kill 100 Necrons, for instance, could be a mission requirement, or kill 100 Guardsmen, something like that. So plot how you try your battles as effectively as you can to try and maximize what you're doing. Very worth bearing that in mind. It's also worth bearing in mind that when you have a large raid numbers, perhaps 250 battles, 75 battles, 50, whatever, you're going to run into a bottleneck, and that bottleneck is energy. There are ways around that. So one of the most obvious, but one that escaped me for quite a while, embarrassingly long period of time actually, is that the early missions in Indomitus only use 3 energy. So for each one of those, you can do 2 of those missions for every 6 energy that you would expend on some other campaign. So just to bear in mind, you've got plenty of potential. So for about 81 energy, something like that, I think that's how the maths goes. 9 for each, and there's 9 for each, and there's 9 of those. You can do a substantial number of battles for a relatively small energy expenditure. And bear in mind as well, the ones beyond that, they are still at 5 rather than 6. So you can still save energy by doing it that way. So bear in mind, this may be of some use to you. I mean, it depends. Obviously, if you're trying to do upgrades on other characters at the time, you might want to just say, sod it, I will just do my raids on battles that have things that I want, rather than the kind of basic stuff that you get in early Indomitus. But it is a point that you can bear in mind. As far as energy goes as well, I don't know what your guys' policy is as far as Blackstone purchases during the course of the day. What I generally do is I'll watch the free advert, and if you're not watching the free advert, why the hell not? You get some free Blackstone for doing it. I mean, assuming you can. Some people do have issues with them. But assuming you can get the energy just by watching an advert, or in my case, starting the advert, muting it, and looking at something else for the 30 seconds. There's only so many bloody Raid Shadow Legends or State of Survival adverts I can watch before I want to claw my eyes out. So bear in mind, you can get energy that way, but I also tend to go in for the 50 Blackstone spend to get additional energy as well. There's 110 beyond that, 250 beyond that as well. I mean, depending on how hard you want to push yourself, you could maybe go 50 and 110 per day. Again, it depends on your Blackstone reserves. I generally do the 50, and that because I have enough of a reserve, and generally the Blackstone that you get over the course of a day, if you're spending the day solidly doing stuff and opening crates, pretty much replenishes itself. So you should always be doing at least a free advert, and probably I'd recommend at least a 50 if you've got the reserves for it. That will give you extra energy, and you can channel it into doing what you need. A point as well, as I said in earlier ones, you have various salvage run conditions. There's free salvage run mission, again 12 hour wait, so you've got to have the salvage runs ready. Don't be doing game modes unless you absolutely have to. There's a 2 guild raid one. Now in the past, the event has started and it's been going across a guild raid reset period, and that's obviously meant you've had to race to get to the guild raid mission and get past it before it shuts down for a day and a half. But this time, thank the dark gods, the guild raid season has just started, so you won't have that issue. Bear in mind, you do 2 guild raid missions. I think usually what happens is that the second condition for that particular quest is that you have to do 10,000 ability damage, something like that. Maybe 20,000, I can't remember. But either way, if you're doing 2 guild raids, odds are you can rattle that out really, really easily. Not even a big deal. And 1 onslaught, I think, is one of the missions. I don't know if they've mixed things up. I'm just obviously going off what I know from previous events. But yeah, 1 onslaught is pretty straightforward. I always like to keep one in reserve. It just comes in very handy that way. Yeah, and again, arena. You should absolutely not be using arena unless you have no other choice, because it's, say, 3 times you have to do 20 missions. So really be stockpiling your arena tokens wherever possible. Don't just be casually playing them. Crates in arena, not really that important at that stage. Yeah, so that's a few things to bear in mind there. Obviously, think carefully about how you're doing your resources. I tend to go quite in hard on getting the characters. I like to get them. I like to level them as high as I can. Neurothrope is one I am particularly excited about collecting, so I am just going to work my ass off to try and get it. Try and get it as high as I can. There was an additional point. One of the later missions, some of the later missions, can be a little bit problematic because you have to obviously deploy the character and like have it deploy and survive in 5 battles, and it has to do a certain amount of damage. And obviously that's difficult because we don't have any Tyranid campaigns. The solution here, there are solutions. Obviously Salvage Run is a good one, Xeno's Salvage Run. Really, you shouldn't be losing any characters in Xeno's Salvage Run. So you can deploy it in there, he can survive, and it will be fine. Arena is also an option if you really need to. Just bear in mind, you'll probably want to hang the character back because it'll be quite weak, and get your 4-man team to do the killing. As long as it survives, that's the main thing. Onslaught, Xeno's Onslaught again is also an option. Depending on how far along you are in that. For instance, in Xeno's Onslaught, I am in level 31. So if I deploy a freshly unlocked Neurothrope, it will get minced. Absolutely fucking minced. It won't even be funny. But depending on how far along you are in Xeno's Onslaught for that, that's an option as well. But generally, you want to play it safe. Maybe go Salvage Run and Arena are your best bets there for getting it unlocked. I mean, obviously with Sarquail that we did recently, it was pretty easy because you could just bop him in any old Imperial Indomitus campaign mission and he would do great guns. A little bit harder for the Neurothrope, but it can be done. And again, just bear in mind, don't use up your tokens for game modes that the Neurothrope can be deployed in if you then unlock that mission and you're like, well, now shit, I have to wait. It's just about thinking ahead, trying to keep tokens for everything in reserve, try and avoid holding yourself up, and yeah, just play as much as you can, really. Have fun. I do enjoy it. It's frenetic. Some of the missions are frustrating. Oh yeah, do 100, use 150 Xeno's abilities. That one's always death to me. That's sort of so horrific, and that really slows it down. Whichever event you're doing, it's just a right pain in the ass. But you know, it's fun. You get a good character at the end of it, and that's pretty much all I have to say. I'm sure I'm going to remember something that I should have mentioned after I've finished recording this video, and I'm going to kick myself. Feel free to mention in the comments if you think I have left anything out. But yeah, as I say, I hope this video has been useful. As I say, it's primarily aimed at newer players, but it's always good to have a little refresh and things to be bearing in mind when you hit an event running. Yeah, all right. So good luck in the event, everyone. Thank you for watching. Until next time.